rescued from the U.S. Embassy to Dili by Delta forces stationed at the nearby training grounds of the Timorese Defense Force. All but one of the hostages have been accounted for, though. Continue to voice protest at Japan's formation of an information self-defense force, promising sanctions of both. Responded to General Kellner's announcement of increased U.S. military presence in East Timor with cautious support, justifiably wary of the response from neighboring.
Saulnier Cryogenics Lab, Paris, France, March 30, 2006, 04, 12 hours. Identify Sadono's chief mercenary. An enemy agent operating under the alias Modified Penguin has broken into the Saulnier Cryogenics Lab with a gang of French and Syrian mercenaries. Trace their path of intrusion to uncover their purpose and the identity of Modified Penguin. Greetings, fellow audience. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow. This is essentially today's mission would be Saulnier Cryogenics, and it's a pretty script-heavy mission, I feel like, with a lot of platform elements. And yeah, we'll see what this mission plays like as
well. Welcome to Paris. You'll have time for sightseeing later.
Thanks, Lambert.
Grim extracted enough from Saulnier's security systems to trace Modified Penguin's movements, but we don't know why, what he wants, or who he is.
Is he still inside?
Hard to say. The man's cover is rock solid.
Are you saying he's CIA?
If he is, he's under deeper cover than I've ever seen. We've got intel linking him to at least a dozen French-Syrian terrorists.
As Modified Penguin?
The email alias is all we've got. It's ridiculous, but that's probably the point. Like the smiley face on a cobra's hood.
Interesting simile there. Probably should have saved beforehand, but okay. Just go ahead and save here, and yeah. So this mission is rather linear. I don't expect to recall how linear it is, but yeah. I mean, I'm not really in much danger from this guy, but yeah, the good thing is we have our gun since the very beginning of the game here. And I'm going to attempt to maneuver around this guy. I have mostly forgotten how this level plays out, so yeah, forgive me. Forgive me any mistakes that I make. This is essentially what I'm trying to say. I'm just gonna try and pick up the pace a little here. Now, the thing about Pandora Tomorrow is that if you look directly at the lights, they'll sort of blind you. I don't know what happens, just that it does. And the next section is... this section is a little tricky, is what I would say. I mean, there are...
What? What? I thought you said something.
You're jumpy. Calm down.
How long do you think it'll take them to find the Frenchmen?
What do you mean, Frenchmen? We're all Frenchmen here.
I mean the French Frenchmen.
The security guard?
Yeah.
I don't know. We must have unfriended my equipment.
I hope the others don't leave without us.
Yeah, so basically I think what we can do is just step outside of this platform and just go for it. I do not recall how easy it was though. Yeah, this guy does come in. Although I think I can sneak past him pretty easily like this. But what I need to be careful of is the other guy over there. Yeah, because he literally looks right towards you and starts walking towards you. I mean, this was supposed to be a pretty easy thing to do if timed correctly, but then again, yeah, I didn't exactly time it correctly. I should have gotten off the track sooner, is what I feel like. Let me just stay here. Let that guy go. Yeah. Did you know? Now I wonder if that guy, if I am in any danger from that guy, but I think what I have to do here, right here, is shoot these things to essentially nullify.
Good, you're in. Grim's daughter suggests first accessing the security terminal on your floor, so she can investigate network activity in the complex.
She can't do it remotely.
No, the important files are off the grid. His case file says the founder was worried about the government stealing his client's files when the apocalypse rolls around.
Paranoia-based security.
That's our mantra.
Yeah, I sort of miss the humor in the more modern Tom Clancy's games. You know, Splinter titles. Okay, so basically what happened was we were switching the lights off in this room, and that essentially triggered this guy to, you know, somehow be able to tell that the lights were switched off in this room. Even though he's not able to, he should not really be able to tell whether the door has been, you know, opened or not. But somehow he's able to tell that the lights have been switched off. And let's see here. Oh yeah, he just sort of keeps making rounds there. I suppose. I'm not sure. I think I might have dug myself into a corner here. Yeah, so I think we are safe to just go ahead and follow this guy. I could be wrong, of course. And let that guy go ahead and check that area. This column, this row of shelves. I've forgotten a majority of this game being the reason why. My memory is a little hazy about whether or not I'm playing this game correctly. I do not recall if there is anything of importance in that laptop over there, but yeah. Yeah, I think I went into the wrong part of the room again.
I can't even find a directory. They've got their whole system on a command line OS. What'll the boss do to us if we don't find the guard?
Half of what he does to our families.
Right.
I mean, these guys are pretty quick to acknowledge their, fates, so to speak. And I suppose that's that, you know, in case I fuck up. There should be a safe spot here. Door, can you close please? I mean, they should not be able to see me from here, and I think the only thing that's keeping the door open is me being right next to it, so yeah, this should be sufficient, I believe. So yeah, Saulnier Cryogenics, it's a pretty iffy level as far as I remember. I'm just gonna have to pick the lock here. I hope I don't get spotted while doing this. I do not suppose there's reason for me to get spotted, but you never know. Oh yeah. I'm gonna restore my health in full. The soundtrack doesn't really add up to the ambience of the game, but I'll take it. Whatever works, I guess. Do it all over again. So what happened was this section, right. Oh wait, no, it's a different section.
Every inch of the auditorium, we never know.
Every inch of the auditorium, huh? I think I'm gonna have to go up through the stairs there. Yeah, I don't really see any other path. Unless this pipe is something that I can grab onto. Did not think so. Oh, there. Ah, nice. I completely missed that pipe. My bad. I mean, it is right behind the door as well, so... Yeah. Okay. Let's see, let me just go ahead and fix it right here. Okay, somehow somebody saw me for whatever reason and I cannot figure out why. But I'll try to go along this pipe without alerting anybody. Hopefully it wasn't that guy. Quite strange how this game just, you know, bugs out every now and then and causes people to just randomly detect you when they really shouldn't be able to, but I guess that's just part of the gameplay experience.
There's somebody in there.
Really? Where? How could you tell? Yeah, I suppose this is as far as I go because that light there is sort of illuminating me. All these people have satchels and I wonder what data sets they're carrying. Too bad I can't exactly... You know, this is gonna be a no-no about run, so yeah, I can't exactly just go ahead and knock them out and... True, nothing here. No duplicate patches all up in a bunch. Inches from my face, huh? Now, what's going to be difficult is timing it so that I can make it through without being seen.
Confirm. The basement is clear. I repeat. Basement clear. I proceed now and destroy all the computers.
Fisher, we need those access codes.
Oh, come on. I really like this, hovering reticle. I mean, it sort of makes a lot of sense, you know. Shows you where the bullet is going to go, exactly going to go. I mean, in my humble opinion, if there was anything good that Ubisoft Shanghai ever did, it was making these reticles, the swing reticle.
I'm in.
Great work, Fisher. What do we got, Grim?
Let's see. Mortified Penguin cracked their system directories. Looks like all of his attention was focused on the client databases.
Meaning, he was looking for specific frozen dead men. What do the client databases say?
Nothing from here. It's a separate network. Oh my god.
What?
What?
The mercenaries just remote triggered a bomb timer.
Where is it?
The signal is coming from the boiler room, further down the corridor.
Okay, this section is a little confusing. I mean... There's a guy that comes out and starts, chatting this guy up. And I don't really know how to handle this section. there don't really seem to be many paths that I can take, and this guy is pretty vigilant about his watch. I apologize for the sound in the background. There's one guy that comes over from business in the middle of the night, like the literal middle of the night. So don't we have like a disposable pick? Yes, we do. Where's the bomb? I've got it.
Okay, done.
Well done. Now you can access the database. That's one floor up, and your next objective.
Now, what I need to equip is this thing. But first, let me just go ahead and check whether the coast is clear. I think it is, I do not see the other guy there. Yeah, so the soundtrack is sort of blaring in my ears right now. Let me just go ahead and adjust that. Music volume, I'll just lower it a little because it's way too loud. Way too loud. Yeah. Should be better now. Yep, the guy's gone. All but disappeared. Let me just check out the store and. Okay, it's that section. Yeah, so this is basically part 2 of Saulnier Cryogenics, and it still is a pretty bad chapter. That flashy thing up ahead, it's sort of like a wall mine, but not exactly. It's like a motion sensor, so you need to just move very cautiously and basically try not to trip it, and that's all there is to that. And I think this is the only place where there's, you know, in the entirety of Pandora Tomorrow that you can get to see the motion sensor. And it's actually pretty damn sensitive because you can see it from miles away. Like, it can see you from miles away. Yeah. The gangster corner. I like to call it gangster corner because one of the... goons up ahead, you know, just comes over to this corner and strikes up a gangster pose. Look at this guy. The OG. Now, I don't know whether it's because of... the fact that I can, but... yeah, I definitely like to scum save. Sorry, save scum. In, you know, Splinter Cell, or literally anywhere I have the opportunity, because... primarily because, you know, this... in games with a lot of scripted events, I just... I think it's a better idea to just, you know, keep saving.
I found the guard on the security cameras. I think you were right. It looks like he's behind that big vault type door. The label on the monitor says body processing room.
That door? Could be. But anyway, let me just go ahead and save here. That guy noticing you. I think. I don't know how he noticed me, but he apparently did. Maybe could he see me through that window over there? At any rate, I guess I'll just go ahead and try and... so basically there's like a camera in the center, and we've got to try whatever we can to... well, basically not get seen by it. Oh. There are multiple cameras, not just one.
I'm inside the client storage database.
I'm tapped. Taking a look, see? I see at least 8 clients Mortified Penguin pulled up in detail.
Anything in common?
All frozen in the last 6 months, and all cheapskates. They all booked economy tickets to the future, just their brains frozen. The low-end storage device is called an ND-133, vacuum-powered refrigeration.
Where did Mortified Penguin hit next?
Limited storage. It's where Saulnier stows all the ND-133s.
That sounds like your next objective, Fisher. Find us some French brains.
I won't promise anything.
Do your best. Details on your opsat.
Okay, so from the looks of these cameras, not up infrared, so what I could probably do is stick to that corner of the wall because it seems to be far less lit. So let me just go to quick save here. So let me just wait, that's not it. It would be 2, 4, 5, 7, right? And what else? What else? What else? I don't really need the health right now, but goddamn, that is a pretty difficult room, I would say. Now, what can I do here to sort of like bring that guy over? Because, oh wait, this one is open, isn't it? Oh no, it's not. But first things first, they just go and save you.
Turn those back on.
Okay, yeah, I will as soon as you come in. Actually, you can do it yourself. So, yeah. Is the door closed yet? Yes, it is. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open this door and I'm gonna go a little up ahead, get into the shadows, and I'm just gonna save the game here. Quick save. Because, yeah, there are way too many things here, and we just gotta take something or the other out here. Like, we need to take out either the camera or the wall mine, because there's no way that, you know, you can match the pace of the camera while trying to, you know, protect yourself from the camera. Sorry, match the pace of the camera while, you know, moving towards the wall mine. So, I mean, it is possible, probably is, but yeah, this is just a safer route. And I'm not exactly looking to do, you know, Splinter Cell parkour at this stage. So yeah, just like the you know, previous Splinter Cell title in the series, just suffered from lots of, what do you call it, like, issues with just wasteful design. Yeah, this one suffers the same as well. And I think I should probably... Oh no, that's not what I wanted to do. These guys are doing something over here. We'll just go and save here. It's generally been like... I'll just wait for that guy to start moving, I suppose, and then I'll go and kidnap this other guy. Or not, or I could probably like just go ahead and sneak a chance at this computer right now. and let this be it. I think we should get the... Yeah, we should have 7562. Yeah, I think this is the play. I think this is the play. Yeah, this is the play. The scripted events in this level are sort of insane. Like, just because I was next to the telephone, it rang, and that's not something I can forgive.
I've got your French brains, Lambert.
So that's what happened to them.
Mortified dumped the clients and took the ND-133.
I guess we can assume he's not CIA, if he's willing to murder.
Murder frozen organs. You can't murder the dead.
Semantics. I think we've got a way to ID the penguin. The security guard everybody's so excited about? His name is Francois Codebeuf. Our intercepts suggest he got a lucky picture of mortified penguin with his cell phone, was wounded, and locked himself inside body processing.
Processing?
Where they pull the brains out of the skull. Introduce yourself to Mr. Codebeuf and get that phone.
Roger, roger. Yeah, let me just go and save it. Because, golly, that last section took me a lot of tries. So, this next section is probably... Wait, was that a... Is that a turret? Like an automated turret? Oh no. But at least I can switch it off from here, I suppose. I'm just gonna go ahead and deactivate it. Excuse me. Yeah. So that makes my job a little bit easier for me, I suppose. I mean, this area is still full of, you know, cool stuff, but I do suppose it makes my job a little easier. Now, I don't know what the play is here, so I'm just gonna quick save. And hope that I'm not making a mistake of any sort. Let's hope that this does not make any sounds, and let's pick the lock. Of course, we can't see what I'm picking or anything. But, oh yeah, this section. Right. Yeah, right. Quick saving. Yeah, so let me just go and take these thermal goggles off, because apparently I cannot see steam with them on, or whatever these things are. These jets of,
I'm at the body processing room, and it looks like you were right. Norman said he wounded the guard, and there's blood on the door handle. Don't stop searching the rest of this dungeon, but I'm gonna need some help to get past this door. It's built like a vault.
Roger, roger. Yeah, I don't know whether we should just retry that section, because... Yeah, that's like a bug. I don't know whether that's a bug on the PC, or just a bug when you're using DG Voodoo or modern hardware or what, but that's not supposed to happen. They sort of hear your footsteps even though they can't really see you, and they go into this entire search pattern and make you wait there for, well, infinity. Until infinity. So, yeah.
I hear something.
Of course you do. Good thing you don't see me. So yeah, I just have to go in and basically... Let me squeeze. Button number 3.
Whatever it was isn't here anymore. My eyes are playing tricks on me.
Okay, that's a pretty nice shuffle walk you got there, sir. At any rate, what we need to do is just silently move in. And, yeah. Just get into this room, and that's all we need to really do. And now I'm just gonna go ahead and make a quick save here. Okay, let's do it one more time then.
Aim at the handle. Stop, stop! It's obviously not working.
What would you suggest?
I'm sure there's some kind of fuel in this place we could use.
Take a look, we'll keep trying here. Maybe if we can't reach the guard, you can cook him.
Don't hurt me, please. I'm just doing my job.
I'm not here to add to your troubles. Are you badly hurt?
No. I'm living, I think. You are?
I'm from the phone company. There's been a recall.
What?
I'm gonna need to take your telephone.
I'm very confused.
Give me the phone, Francis.
So that's Mortified Penguin. Compliment Mr. Kotobuf on his photography.
We got a facial match off CIA databases. Norman Soth, U.S. citizen.
What's that ID code? Does it mean he's an agency asset?
No, it means they don't know.
I'm running him through Echelon. We could have a location on him within the hour.
Great work, everybody. Make yourself scarce, Fisher. Cohen's waiting outside for extraction.
Right.
Right what?
Yeah. Just get a good angle. Yeah. So yeah, that's pretty much the solution to, you know, clearing out this wall of ours. And I think that's the extraction there. Yep. And a really bright flash of the screen to accompany the, what do you call it, the mission complete mission, message. Saulnier Cryogenics Labs, Paris, France, March 30th, 2006, 05:23 hours. I think it took him around an hour, which is shorter than what it took me. Anyway, mission complete. A recovered image of mortified Benton matched the CIA record of agency-trained operative named Norman Soth. Though Echelon was unable to identify Soth as either a friendly or enemy asset, Grim Sergeant successfully traced him to a train en route to Nice under the alias Jonathan Poindexter. Now, the next mission is probably one of my favorite missions in Pandora Tomorrow. I played it a lot as a child in the Pandora Tomorrow demo. And yeah, while I adore the mission, it's also heavily scripted. Like, probably the most scripted mission in Splinter Cell history. So yeah, I personally have a preference of not liking missions like those. Being one of the reasons why I don't like Pandora Tomorrow as much. And I had to retry this mission a lot of times, primarily because of all the scripted events and the ways that this game just, you know, tries to fuck with you if you don't exactly go for the solution that the devs intended for you. I might include a few examples as bloopers after this. What I can do is just come over here and wait, I suppose. I'm not entirely certain whether him walking over 7562, okay. Whether him walking over his friend is gonna alert him or not, so I'm not gonna save yet. But what I am gonna do is wait for this guy. I mean, typically, how the stealth... But, let's see. But, yeah, there were a few instances where, like, a phone rang because I was right next to it. It was not something that was supposed to happen. Otherwise, I mean, I waited for the phone to ring the next time, but it never rang. So, yeah, this game sort of has a habit of fucking with it, apparently. And, it's just very heavily scripted, very, you know, linear solutions to the stealth puzzles. Essentially, a stealth game is essentially a puzzle game with elements of timing and, you know, a few other dynamics here and there. This mission was a little bit of a hassle for me, primarily because I forgot most of it, but yeah, it was sort of a hassle for me. I used to look back at this level pretty fondly, although I cannot see the scene right now anymore. So yeah, that's that for this mission. That's that for today. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back to Splinter Cell, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, Pandora Tomorrow, rather, we are going to be completing the mission called Train. I think that's what the mission is called. But yeah, it's got like really cool visuals, and it's a very short and sweet sort of a mission. Very short and sweet sort of level. So yeah, until then, take care. Farewell for all things.